Hello everyone, welcome to this video series where we want to compare the career options that you have after finishing your studies in Netherlands or masters or something like that. So we have here two friends who are doing PhD and PD engineering in Netherlands. So they agreed to share their experiences of how you get into that kind of a program and what are the challenges or other kind of experiences that you get when you enter the program and what how it goes on throughout the program. So I will leave it to them so that they will give a short introduction and then we'll move on with the discussion to give you guys some information of what you can do after masters or after studying in Netherlands.
Okay, hi guys, my name is Vibhor and I'm doing my PhD in Netherlands. This is my second year. So I'm just going to give a brief idea of how I ended up here. I'm a PhD just like my friend Sambit. He already has his channel and must have told you guys a lot about how PhD life is in Netherlands. So many things may not be that different, but still my background is different. So I just let you guys know how I ended up here. I did my bachelor's in India in Bits Goa. In mechanical, and I worked there for some time in a firm in a mechanical core company, and after that I realized after working for some months I realized that I need to do master studies to further advance my career. So I applied for a master's program in materials engineering in Netherlands. I completed it in 2 years, and after I completed my master's, I was not sure if I want to do a PhD or I want to go for a job. But anyways, I was keeping my options open. Fortunately, within my department, there was an opportunity of a PhD, which was a kind of a mix of industry as well as academic. You can better call it an industrial PhD. So you have to stay in contact with industry, carry out their project, but in academic setting. So this seemed to me like a very good option, and the company which was involved, Tata Steel. I also did my master's internship at that company for 3 months. So I knew I had some good impression on people there. And yeah, so I applied. There were the selection process was quite thorough. It was not a easy process to get through, but yeah, knowing certain people certainly helped. And till now, it's been a very nice experience. I just completed my first year and I passed my go no go meeting, which is held after 1 year, where they decide whether to continue your PhD or not. So, but in my case, they were very happy, and now I'm going to go. Just entered my second year, and hopefully, I'll be ending up with a PhD, with a doctor before my name. So, yeah, that's all about me. I'll now. Yeah. All over to her.
Hi guys, I'm Bhavya, and I'm enrolled in the PD engineering course, which is professional doctorate in engineering. So I don't think people know a lot about this degree. It's actually a Dutch degree. It's mainly in Netherlands that you see it, and it's a post-master course, which is a 2-year course, and it's provided in some particular fields only. So first I'll tell you how I landed over here. I did my bachelor's in chemical engineering in Bits Goa along with Vibhor. And then I took a master's course in India itself and did it in polymer engineering After that, I worked for a few years, and then I realized that I wanted to do something more, and something related to designing, which is more useful in industry. I wasn't focused on going for a research career, but I wanted to be more industry focused, with having some conceptual design involved career. So I got to know about this course, and I applied for this course. Then the process for the course is generally you, like a PhD, you write a motivation letter, give your CV, and then they choose you. So you are, the course in this way, it's more different than PhD, that it is a 2-year course. And it's not a 4-year course where you have to do all the research. So it's more industry focused. And you do 1 year of your curriculum courses and 1 year of industrial project with a company over here. Yeah, that's it.
One more thing, that you also get paid.
Oh yeah, that's the biggest advantage. That it's
important thing, yes.
You are an employee, you are not a student. So you get a salary over. That is the biggest selling point of this course, yeah, I'd
so
say.
So you get the salary to study stuff.
Yes, and you also get the advantage. Yeah,
it's a very nice.
And which specialize?
So this is like, I'm doing it in Delft University, but this PDEng degree, it's given by 3 universities in Netherlands. It's in Delft, Eindhoven, and Twente. All 3 universities provide the PDEng course in different tracks. In Delft, it's mainly in 4 tracks. 3 of them are in chemical department, chemical and biological department, and 1 of them it's in civil engineering. So I am doing it in chemical product design, which is one of the chemical tracks. And the other 2 tracks are process equipment design and the bioprocess engineering. Yeah, so it's up to you. Whichever stream you are interested in, you can look for it. Even in other universities like Twente and Eindhoven, you'll find the tracks based on chemical engineering and many other fields also.
Yeah, I know that there are in Eindhoven and Twente, there used to be PDEng tracks even in mechanical engineering as well, electrical as well. So
electrical, yeah, is there. Mechanical, I think materials, it's there in Eindhoven probably. Mm. 20 doesn't has it.
I think okay. So something computer science.
Yeah, that I don't know that different tracks. So
yeah,
people
so
who are interested in this sort of a study, they should definitely look into it.
Yes, it's a really good course because learn about a lot about the designing product or a process, and it gives you an edge over the other people in industry. If you really want to have your career in industry but not much focused on research, it's a very good course to go for.
This is another thing that this PD engineering course is it's basically a Dutch degree, right?
It's a Dutch degree.
And I think apart from Netherlands, it's valid in Belgium. Many companies in Belgium also accept this, but
yeah,
outside Belgium and Netherlands, people don't really recognize
it. It's not recognized all over Europe so much, but in few countries it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but slowly it's being spread a lot now.
So thank you for this elaborate discussion. Continuing the discussion further. So what are actually the differences in the career options that you have after PhD and PD engineering respectively? So maybe we can have a brief discussion on that.
Yes, after PhD, it's quite well known, the career options. Either you can go into academia, but you can also go into R&D in an industry. Different people, different choices. But there are other things which not many people explore. Those are things like you can, when you do a PhD, you actually become good in many things. You become good in large data analysis. You become very good in project management, and you become very good with deadlines and giving presentations in conferences and in your group. Yeah, so you can make a good use of it, and you can actually join companies who require consultants regarding some for example, if someone some company needs a consultant for maintenance of a lab, of a lab which contains very costly equipments, so they need someone who has actually worked in a lab environment, and these kind of jobs, as well as jobs where companies require people who are good with number crunching and data visualization. So when you're doing your PhD, you want to represent your data in a most effective way, and you become good at it, and you can make use of it. You can go to the company and say, I know how to do very nice data visualization. There can be several options after PhD, but you need to keep your mind open and constantly search for where your skills can be put to good use.
Starting new company.
Yeah, starting new companies as well. There's very good infrastructure and help available here in Netherlands for people who want to start a startup.
Even in the university we have.
Yes, in the university also we have Yes Delft and organizations. And even inside the university or outside the university, there are a lot of incubation centers in Netherlands. So they take care of all the legalities, paperwork and everything, and you can just focus on your product. I don't have much idea about the startup procedure, but it's from some of my friends who have been in this, their experience has been very nice. So yeah, that's it for PhDs. Moving on to career options after PDEng.
So in PDEng also you have various options. You can stick to the industrial area, you can go for a job, even at times you get an option to continue in the same company where you worked your project in your second year. You did your internship there, and there is another option of going for research also. At times what happens that you develop interest in research when you are working on a project. So it depends on your project also. You got into some kind of research-based project, let's say. In that case, some people have seen that, yeah, they have developed more interest into that area, and there are a few examples from past that people have gone for a PhD after PDEng. So it doesn't limit you anywhere. There is no boundary actually. So it just helps you to develop more skills this course, and these skills could be used anywhere. And apart from the PhD also, you can go for in case of PhD, we both suggested consultant jobs. People do go for consultant jobs. People even go for their own companies. So entrepreneurship is also one option.
Yeah.
And this PD engineering course, especially in Delft, the curriculum for first year is really nice. There are some compulsory courses which you do. Those courses involve so many skill-based requirements, so you develop all those skills. Like you have course in project management, so it helps you to develop managerial skills, and it's not anything related to technical, but it's non-tech, that how you'll work in professional environment, that helps you. You get coaching sessions over there where you can talk to the coaches and discuss the real life problem in professional life.
So basically,
also,
apart from the traditional technical courses,
yes,
you get
other so
courses
much,
which enhance your
useful
personality.
Enhance it. You get so much of confidence. You develop your personality on that basis.
Yeah, yeah.
And then there are courses like techno-economic evaluation. You don't do it in any technical field as such, but in this course you actually work on economic analysis of a you work on so many case studies, and then you work on your own project.
They're actually preparing you for industry.
And yes, it is. And if we talk to alumni, they tell you that this is one of the most useful course, because in every project you can do some basic economic analysis, and that is very helpful, because you can see, like, you can be far-sighted with that project at the initial phase itself.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that helps you.
Yeah.
And then there are some design-based courses which are more focused on the degree itself, the design degree. and then you get some electives. So that way you can widen up your knowledge background. It's completely up to you which field base you want to take those electives.
Yeah, just one more point. I've seen several people before joining PDEng, they have this question that since this degree is only valid in Netherlands and some parts in Belgium, how much would it matter if they want to move out of Netherlands after doing PDEng and want to search for a job outside Netherlands, Belgium? So what can be an approach
I feel it's always good if you initially try to look for a job over here itself within the Europe, because
within Netherlands, right?
Within Netherlands and the countries where the
this is recognized,
more. Mm-hmm. Because they know the value of the degree. Mm-hmm. And you actually could make use of the degree over there. Mm. Instead of going back to your home country like India
or even other countries such as US and Canada and Australia,
they don't recognize. They are not so
not also all the countries in Europe recognize this degree.
Not every country do.
Yes.
But yeah, like slowly it is being recognized. Mm-hmm. As I said before, yeah, still there are some loophole, like lagging points over now. Yeah. Over here. Mm. So you can initially, it always goes to work over here because it later on that work experience would add on to the
then you can
thing.
Take advantage. Yes.
And apart from it, there is one thing more, that you can always show this course in other countries where it's not recognized as a traineeship. That point could be added on your CV.
Yes, because in the second year you have project with the industry.
Apart from it, in the first year itself you do projects. Mm. So you work on 4 to 5 months minimum on a group project, mm-hmm. which is again with a company.
Mm. Yes.
So you can put all those things. So it's the way you put these things in your CV, how they you represent them.
Yeah.
And it could be even modified in that way. And if you're able to convince another company in your home in India about this program, maybe.
Dutch companies in India.
Or Indian
chemical
company. Yeah.
Like, share and subscribe to Sambit's YouTube channel. Sambit has been getting a lot of feedback, positive feedback from via his channel, and we are really glad that our friend is helping out so many people, and we try our best to help him as well. So all the best to you. And I hope you keep benefiting from all the videos Sambit make in future as well.
Yes, so don't forget to like,
share and
subscribe to the video.
So before signing off, I want to give a big thumbs up for our cameraman. He helped us a lot in shooting these videos and making it possible. And you might have seen him in many of the previous videos. So I don't think I need to talk more about it.
It's been a pleasure to help Sambit.
Thank you very much for also spending your time and making this video possible. And if you have not seen this location, so this is the Tudor Library. Maybe I'll shoot a separate video on the library.
Hello everyone.